so we're doing the dissolved oxygen test. We're reminding you that the oxygen in the water is causing our first reagent, manganese 2 plus, to be oxidized to manganese 4 plus. That in turn then causes the iodide ion to be converted to the brown iodine molecule. Now, as we had the StreamWatch kit, we were able to work out the brownness of the water, which is related to the concentration of oxygen present at the beginning, using the colorimeter. Here we're about to look at the other process we need to do if we did not have a colorimeter, and that's titrating with thiosulfate, that's its formula, with a starch indicator. Now, there are three sets of equations that are relevant, and we're wanting to show you that the first two are actually the complicated form of our little scheme over here, and then we're wanting to process the data we've got in a specific example to work out the oxygen concentration the long way using titration. So I'm wanting to show you that this is actually manganese 2, this is actually manganese 4, which relates to this part, that this is actually iodide. We can see that without too much worry going to iodine. So it's this part, and this third equation is where the titration comes in because we can't use the colorimeter. So just checking on these oxidation numbers up here for the first one. Manganese hydroxide. Manganese would have to have had a 2 valency to cancel out with the valency for the hydroxide. So it is a 2 in that equation. And in this complex, the best way to come up with the oxidation for manganese is to know that whatever it is, it has to balance out the fact that it's an oxygen and 2 lots of hydroxides. So overall is a minus 4 charge, so hence the manganese would be plus 4. So they are the same two equations, whether you work out your oxygen concentration via colorimetry or using the titration. Now, in our sheet, it tells us that Angelo titrated and found that to get the color change for the indicator, using starch as an indicator, the starch blue color disappears, that's when we stop the titration, and he needed 20 mils of 6 moles per litre. So that relates to 0.024 moles of thiosulfate. And this is where we need to be careful with our equations. So here we've said we've got 0.024 of a mole of thiosulfate. That was due to the fact we had a certain amount of oxygen to kick off the process. So we need to go back and to see what the corresponding amount of oxygen would be. And this is how we do it. What's relevant here are the balancing numbers. 2 of that for 1 of that. It's just my iodine, pardon me, 1 of that. 1 iodine here for 1 of those. 2 of those to 1 of those. They're the numbers we'll be looking at. So the reasoning goes that if we had 0.024 moles of thiosulfate, we would have reacted it with 0.012 of the iodine, 1 to 2 ratio. We have 0.012 of the iodine came from the same amount of the manganese complex, 1 to 1. This is the amount of the complex we had, and the corresponding amount of oxygen that started the process would have been half of that, 0.006. So over here then, to follow that calculation through, remember we're wanting the concentration of oxygen. Concentration of oxygen is the number of moles divided by the volume. So we were told that our sample was a 20 mil sample. So doing that calculation, we get an answer of 0.3 moles per litre. But the normal unit for concentration in chemistry of the environment is in milligrams per litre, like our values that we got in using our StreamWatch kit. And the conversion is easy if you remember that mass is equal to moles times formula mass. So I can take my 0.3 moles per litre and say it's the same as 0.3 times 32 grams, because 32 is the formula mass of oxygen. And I'm almost there, I've now got it in grams per litre. If I wanted it in milligrams per litre, I need to times it by 1,000. So with this set of values, we're getting the concentration for the oxygen, very much healthier than the samples we've used, is 9,600 milligrams per litre. And it is wise to remember that milligrams per litre is the same as parts per million. Thank you.